Hey everyone, I want to take you through a quick walkthrough of a plugin I built using ChatGPT actually, and a GPT that's called WordPress Plugin AI. I'm just going to walk through the chat itself just a little bit. It's actually super long, so I'll skip through a few things, but I'll link to that chat so you could see everything yourself, and I'll showcase the plugin from the back end in particular, and talk through a little bit of what I did and how I got there, just to show that my dev skills are not amazing at all. I'm pretty much just dangerous mostly, but with AI, I was able to do a ton more than I ever have done by myself before. So here goes. All right, so first things first, I did this not with Copilot or any of those other code tools, just with ChatGPT Pro, and I have this GPT installed called WordPress Plugin AI. Now, this is a big caveat. I'll go over here. This is what that looks like, and I don't know this author, and honestly, when I go to the website, it doesn't evoke a ton of confidence, honestly, so I have some skepticisms about this GPT in particular, so don't do this based on my recommendation. Do it if you are feeling Wild Westy Cowboy Cody and run with it, because that's what I did. But I tried it out, and I don't know, maybe the difference between using this and just native ChatGPT, maybe there's no difference at all. But I will say I felt like this GPT understood WordPress pretty well. So I just opened it up that said, I need a plugin that will display all my posts in the WordPress admin in a calendar view. That's all I said. I didn't give it any parameters, any other kinds of instructions. It's like, that's what I want. And this first response is honestly pretty darn good, I gotta say. So it's telling you about creating a plugin. It gives me a plugin header. It says I need to register the admin menu. Notice it's doing an admin menu page called posts calendar. That's pretty smart. And all of this works as intended. Now I've got to query the posts and prepare the data for the calendar. That's totally true. And I was impressed also that it says, for simplicity, we'll use Full Calendar, a popular open source JavaScript calendar library. Before I jumped into this, I had actually researched which calendar JavaScript library I'd like to use. And this is the one that I was going to recommend anyway. So this is they went ahead and jumped right into that one. So here it's showing you how you can enqueue those scripts from jsdeliver.net. Not my preference. I probably will download it and do it natively, but this works, and it got up and running really quickly. It also is making sure that those are only enqueued on that page in the admin, which is totally excellent. If it's not this top level page, then these things aren't going to be enqueued. Which is great. It also does the full calendar CSS right there. I did notice that it was using an older version of full calendar, 5.10. Maybe this is because of 2021 indexing. I'm not sure. But that's what it recommended there. And now we need to render the calendar and load posts. Calendar menu page, and this is just a real basic HTML, and here the ID calendar is where that full calendar is going to render that calendar for us, and it has an H1 on the page. All good so far. Example JavaScript, Ajax, and calendar initialization are simplified for brevity. All of this also worked for me out of the box pretty much. This is the initial view it recommended, the day, grid, month view for full calendar. And now we're going to fetch the post through Ajax. Totally true. Totally the way that it has to happen. Post type post. I guess potentially we could do this with the REST API. But I think Ajax is going to load it more on the fly, especially when you switch between months and whatnot. It's going to have to get those older posts. So I definitely had to do some tweaking here and there. But you'll see as you read through this chat that I had to do a lot of changes. Now it says completing the plugin. Basically, it's given all the code, and it says it gives you the basic framework for the plugin that you want, and you'll need to handle edge cases and ensure security, nonce verification, which is absolutely true, and they actually don't do that here. But it does mention that and give code for that later in the chat. And test it thoroughly, of course. Localization, it doesn't do any localization. I don't think there is a string. There is one string that's output here, this H1, basically. Oh, and it is localized, so it just doesn't give you the text domain. It didn't say anything about text domain there. So I don't know if you do this, but with these AI chats, I always converse with them. I'm like, good start. I want them to know that I like what I see. But I want the calendar menu to be a sub menu of the posts menu. How do I do that? So basically, it was a really good first start. It actually worked really well out of the box and got the full calendar into the WordPress admin in the way that I was hoping and expecting. The posts were there. Everything was looking pretty good. I just was like, I don't want it to be its own menu. I want it to be a sub menu of the post area. And was like, no problem. Do this instead. Add sub menu. And here's all the explanation for that. And now what's great here is it also recognizes that these things are need to be explained a little bit. And now I said, you need to update the hook that limits the script from running only on the post calendar view page. It needs to be applied now to the submenu page. And this is where you'll start to see that can everyone build a plugin with ChatGPT or with AI? Not everyone can, honestly, because if you took just this code and just pasted it into a single file, it would work, but you would have very little flexibility and you just would get what you get. And it wouldn't do any more than that. If you want to start customizing these things, you have to know what to look for. And that's one of my big takeaways here. I knew that it did give me the ability to add the submenu page, but if I left everything the way it was, the script wasn't going to load on this page at all because this wasn't the top menu page anymore. It was a sub page. So give me that script for loading it on the submenu page. And it goes, oh yeah, sure. No problem. Here you go. And this also worked pretty much right out of the box. I like that it's doing an explanation every single time because it's also educating you about what these actions and functions do. I'll go a little bit further and then I'll show the plugin. So now I'm telling it, instead of full calendar, what about use the get calendar function? I have never used that function before. I don't know exactly if it would do what I want. I just wanted to throw this at it and see what happens. And it told me how to do it. And I tried it out and it absolutely was not going to work for that purpose at all. So it was actually really educational. It gave me the code to test it out. I tested it out. It just shows a calendar and it doesn't really give me the ability to populate it with posts or anything like that. So learned about that for the first time ever. Okay, I'm going back to full calendar and it was giving me an error. So I asked about that. I will say that what I also learned is I'm on a Windows machine and I use Microsoft and I'm in Edge here, which is a Chromium browser, of course. And when I go to inspect things in the inspector, I can now click on a Copilot icon anytime there's an error. And I'm using AI there as well to teach me about the error and point me in the right direction. I used that a lot as I was building this out, and it was absolutely helpful. So it's not only that I was using ChatGPT and this specific GPT, but I was using Copilot in the browser to troubleshoot things. And when I found the errors, I was able to actually come back in here and ask this plugin what happens about, like, why is it doing a JSON error? It says modify the AJAX handler for fetching the posts. Okay, well, I did that as well, and this actually worked out really good. And it was highlighting to get, here's where it starts to get more specific about security and proper AJAX practices. This was actually really useful and helpful because I don't want to ship this in any way unless it has proper nonce checking, which is, again, something that I know because of my experience as a developer, and not every WordPress user knows these things. Okay, I've made some great progress. Now I need to add some functionality into the calendar view. Now I'm trying to go deeper. First, there should be a button on the bottom of every date with a plus icon and the words add post. What I think is really interesting about this request is it really is requiring this to have a knowledge both of how the full calendar JS is used and how to query things correctly in WordPress as well. So Here, what I don't love is that if I'm not super specific to it, it's going to kind of recap everything for me every single time. So here it's basically saying, well, let's initialize full calendar again. I've already done that. It's already told me about that. I knew what to do here. But the code that it provided every time was just a little bit different every time. So this was the first time it introduced me to this function or this variable in the full calendar JavaScript library, which is day sale content. And this is how you end up outputting these links or buttons into the day view. So that was really helpful. And now I need to implement a quick modal, quick draft modal. It gave me that in a real simple HTML form that I got hidden on the page, no problem. And then it's giving me some JavaScript for how I can open that quick draft modal and populate the input field with the date correctly. And then that modal form, it needs to be able to handle AJAX submissions. So did all of that, and this worked pretty well overall. I had to customize a couple things here and there in order for it to work correctly. It highlights styling and icons. I was not going to load Font Awesome for this purpose when I can use dash icons and things like that. So, and then sometimes I would have to specify, like, it gave me a new way to initialize full calendar, and this was all with vanilla JavaScript, but previously it had given me a jQuery function for initializing the calendar. And so I was working with a jQuery way of initializing, and so I asked it, hey, give me that same code above, but do it with jQuery this time, and it did that, and this worked out pretty good overall. It even highlighted the key changes. So, all right, enough about that. I want to come over here and show off the plugin a little bit. So that's up next. All right, so let me show off the plugin a bit and a few things that I thought were fun and interesting. You'll see here that even though it did, of course, give me that plugin header, I did go ahead and use like a WordPress plugin boilerplate. Again, that's one of the things that most WordPress users wouldn't think to use, but I wanted to kind of beef up this plugin just a tiny bit than it just being a single file. So I dropped in that boilerplate and started dropping in all the functions here. And as you'll see, this is not particularly object-oriented at all. This is all very procedural code the whole time, just really like pasting code into this one long file and then referencing a couple other assets along the way. But over here on the left, you could see the output. You'll see here's the full calendar, and you'll see this is a submenu here, like I intended, and it's showing the calendar and all of these customizations I did in terms of like showing the post status. You'll see that here's a draft, but this one is published, and they're on different dates here. You see that add post button that I had referenced earlier. There's definitely some issues with the overflow of how this is flowing over. Like doesn't look like I can add a post into the 23rd right now because of how this is overflowing. So there's definitely things to improve for sure. But you'll see that when you go to add post, it pops up a draft of post. This is emulated after the quick draft form essentially, but I added a category as well. Anybody who's doing drafting posts real quick, they want to select the category probably in advance as well. And you'll see that when I that the publish date is pre-populated there, no problem. One thing I'm still working on is I also want to be able to update a post. So this has now been added. You'll see the publish date correctly, but not the category, not the title, not the content. I want to pre-populate all those things. And then when you change it, it hits update and it updates that draft for you. And then you'll be able to go on. But you'll be able to switch to these different months, and you could see published and draft that these are all here still. You can run to today. That's all fine. It does have a week view as well. None of these have times associated with them currently, so they all end up looking like all-day events. That might be interesting to apply as well, or you can go to the specific day. And again, once we find one, there are all-day events as well. We can go to today. Nothing's going on today. But and it all works pretty much exactly as intended. One thing that I had a little fun with was I wanted to also make sure that the color scheme was actually working well. I want to highlight real quick this function I put together. Basically, if you choose a different color scheme for your user, it now gets reflected throughout here as well. So I'm going to refresh the page. Yeah, so as you could see, when you get here to the post calendar, content calendar page again, that profile color scheme is reflected everywhere, and you see it in the calendar as well. And that was something I've always wanted to experiment with in terms of using the native WordPress color schemes to impact the UI of the product itself. And I think it actually overall came out pretty good. There are some color schemes I noticed that have less contrast than I would prefer, and so I'd have to get a lot smarter with applying some more contrast to some of them. But overall, for the major ones, it's working pretty well. I actually shared some of that snippet online. So overall, I'm pretty happy with the results, especially because I was able to get this done in less than 2 hours, I would say, overall, which for me is pretty remarkable. So overall, that's an overview of the plugin I had built using ChatGPT and a little bit of help from Copilot as well. I think it's pretty interesting. Honestly, like I said, I got a lot farther, a lot quicker than I expected at all, and pretty impressed with the results. Is it professional code? No. Is it functional? Yes. Does it work? Yes. Is it prone to security issues? Maybe. All kinds of things that definitely could make it a lot better in the hands of a professional developer who knows what they're doing. But nevertheless, check out the article in the description below, and I would love your comments or questions or observations or feedback in the comments here on YouTube, or of course in the article as well. So thanks a bunch, and we'll see you online.